The Liberal NDP carbon tax is hurting everyday Canadians who are just trying to have a nice Thanksgiving dinner with their families. After 8 long years of these Liberals, Canadians have had enough. So why aren't these Liberals axing the carbon tax so Canadians can bring home affordable dinners this Thanksgiving weekend?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. You know, for days and days I listened to Conservatives across the way filibuster a bill that will really make a difference. When you talk about competition, as a government, we want to see competition. That's one of the reasons why we called to the Ottawa, the 5 major grocery chains. What do the Conservatives say? It's an op. When it comes to legislation, what do? Talk, 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 Mr. Speaker. They're not prepared to get behind Canadians when they need to be there in a very real and tangible way. Stand up and vote for the legislation.
The Honourable Member for Selkirk, Interlake, Eastman.
That's like a bunch of gobbledygook. But my writing, some of the best turkey producers are in all of Canada. But the Liberal NDP carbon tax is increasing the cost to feed their turkeys and heat their barns. When the Liberals tax the farmers who grow the food and tax the trucker who ships the food, Canadians have to pay more to buy the food. Canadians know that this Liberal NDP coalition is just not worth the cost. So will the Prime Minister stop his photo ops, get back to work, and ax the carbon tax, or is he just going to wreck Thanksgiving for everyone?
The Honourable Minister of Environment and Climate Change.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I would like to remind my colleague that the dairy farmers of Canada have committed that to reach net zero greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. The Egg Farmers Association of Canada have also announced that they want to reach net zero greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. The Grain Growers Association of Canada, Mr. Speaker, have also committed to reach net zero by 2050. Farmers understand how climate change is impacting their sector and how we need to put measures in place to fight it. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.